To get the most out of Zotero, it's a good idea to set up a little organization for the sources you'll gather. Let's look at the left side of the Zotero window. Similar to iTunes, your file structure will be in the left section, your individual items in the center section, and the details for each item on the right. See the little icon on the left end of the top menu bar, the one that looks like a folder? Click on that to create a folder. Zotero calls this a collection. Most people use folders to store their sources related to a project. You can name a folder for a class or the name of a project. I'm going to call this collection English 4200. Now, any new things I add to Zotero will be added to this folder. I can right-click on the folder to create sub-collections. I'll call this sub-collection Paper 1. If you want to, you can even create sub-collections within sub-collections, but in real life, most people don't. To make a new collection, you can either go back to the icon, or you can right-click on My Library and create it there. My Library is where you can always see all of your stuff in Zotero, no matter what folder it's in. The new My Publications gives you a way to share your publications to others. Look for a later video about that. Duplicate items is a good place to check once in a while. You generally want to avoid having duplicates in your Zotero library, because it will end up messing with your bibliography later. So if you see them starting to crop up because you forgot and added something twice, make sure to merge them together. But you won't have duplicates if you have nothing in your library. The next few videos in this series will show you how to add sources to your library and how to use Zotero to create bibliographies and in-text citations with the greatest of ease.